بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد Dini submission, handing over ourselves completely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not logic, not intelligence, not using our intellect in deducing what's the correct methodology. Maulana Yusuf used to say that غلط يقين یہ بیماری ہے. This incorrect conviction is the sickness. And speaking about Allah, speaking about the greatness of Allah is the shifa, the cure and the remedy. So we need to establish the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fire cannot burn, water cannot quench my thirst, medicine cannot cure me. Money, wealth cannot solve my problems. Everything is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he used to say, we don't tell people go out in a path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because this is one scheme, this is a strategy. We tell people to go out in a path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and speak about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Isliye ye Allah ka haq hai. This is the haq. It is the right of Allah that the greatness of Allah should be spoken about. So we have yaqeen and we have to have this conviction that all solutions to humanity lies only in deen. The solution to every problem only lies in deen. Once Nabi alayhi salam entered the masjid and a Ansari was there, Abu Umama. He said, Ya Aba Umama, ma li araka jalisan fil masjid fi ghayri waqti salah. In the masjid at an abnormal time, what's the hikmat? What's the wisdom? Why are you here? Is there something wrong? He said, Humum lazimatni wa duyun ya Rasulullah. I've got worry, I've got anxiety, I've got stress, I've got issues and I've got debts. So what did Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam do? He turned him to Aamal. Should I not tell you such words? Adhhab Allah Azza wa Jal Hammak wa qada'anka daynak. Allah will remove all your grief and Allah will solve your debt problem. Bala ya Rasulullah. So say those words morning and evening. Make it an often routine. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-hammi wal-huzn wa a'udhu bika min al-'ajzi wal-kasl wa a'udhu bika min al-jubni wal-bukhl wa a'udhu bika min ghalabati dayn wa qahri ar-rijal. The Sahabi said, fa'altu dhalika. I made amal on what my Nabi said, فَأَذْهَبَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ جَلْ هَمِّي وَقَضَعَنِي دَيْنِي. Allah removed all my anxiety and my stress and Allah fulfilled, paid my debts. So, amal is the solution. Yaqeen in amal, not asbab. So from mal to amal, from dunya to akhirat. Hazrat Nawfal bin Harith bin Abdul Muttalib radiyallahu anhu says that I went to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. I was getting married. So Nabi alayhi salam got me married. Then he said, is there anything for you for your needs? He didn't have anything. So he told Abu Rafi and Abu Ayyub to pawn their armor and they got 30 sa' of barley. So the Sahabi says, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam handed the barley over to me. So for half a year passed and I continued eating it. Thumma kilnahu. So you see, we eating, he's not yet finished. Let's see how much is left. So we waited. Fawajadnahu kama adkhalnahu. We found it as it was. So I went to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam and I told him that that 30 sa' that you gave me is exactly still 30 sa'. So Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam told him, لو لم تكله لأكلت منهما عشت. If you had not weighed it, then as long as Allah would have given you life, it would have sufficed for your needs. It would have sufficed for your needs. Imagine what barakah, what khair. Aisha radiallahu anha said that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam passed away and I had nothing to eat. وَلَيْسَ عِنْدِي شَيْءٍ. I had nothing to eat except some barley which was stored on my shelf. فأكلت منه حتى طال علي. I continued eating for a long period. One day I said, let me check how much is left. فَكِلْتُهُ فَفَنِيَا. I weighed it and that came to an end. So can you imagine how much barakah that if a person could continue eating perpetually for the entire life, scientifically beyond human comprehension, beyond human understanding. This is the deen Allah has given us. Continue with barakah. The 24th sabab for barakah is adl, justice. That when there is justice and insaf, then there will be barakah. Like at the time of Isa alayhi salatu wassalam, تَحْصُلُ الْبَرَكَةِ فَيُقَالُ لِلْأَرْضِ. The earth will be told, it will be said, bring forth your fruit and وَرُدِّي بَرَكَتَكَ. That return all the barakah and the blessings thereof. فَيَوْمَ إِذٍ تَأْكُلُ الْعِصَابَ مِنْ رُمَّانَ. That a group of people would able to consume and eat and suffice for their needs from one pomegranate, that's how big it would be. And they would able to seek shelter under its skin. A cow would give so much milk, an entire party group would able to consume and drink from it. A camel will give so much milk, it will be sufficient for an entire tribe. A sheep will give enough milk for an entire family. So barakah, وَيَفِيضُ الْمَالِ حَتَّى لَا يَقْبَلَهُ أَحَدٌ. There'll be so much wealth, there'll be nobody to take that wealth. And Allah will put so much peace at the time. Al-Asad mal-Ibil, that lions will graze with camels. And wolves mal-Ghanam. And with the sheep you'll find wolves. وَيَلْعَبُ السِّبِيَانِ مَعَ الْحَيَّاتِ. And children will be able to play with snakes. Ibn Qayyim, rahimahullah, says that the wheat and the crops were bigger in the past. Why? كَمَا كَانَتِ الْبَرَكَةِ فِيهَا عَذَمْ. Because that time there was more barakah and blessings. So Imam Ahmad has mentioned that at that time in the treasures of the Bani Umayyah, there were a sack فِيهَا حِمْطَ, filled with wheat. And it was like the size of the seeds of kajur, maktubun alayha, and was written on it, hadha kana yumbitu ayyam al-adl. Thus used to grow during the era of justice. Thus used to grow during the era of justice. Like as Ibn Qayyim has mentioned, that فَكُلُّ وَقْتٍ عَسَيْتَ اللَّهِ فِيهِ. That whenever you disobey Allah, or your wealth you use against the awamir of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or ilm, you use it contrary to what you know, or practice in ma'asiyat and sin, then that will be against you. And you do not own that, you start losing the barakah and blessings. And he explains, وَلِهَذَا مِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعِيشُ فِي هَذَا الدَّارِ. There are some people who live to over 100 years, but their lives are as if they've lived for 20 years. And likewise, people who have had troves of treasure and wealth, but it's as if they had nothing. So Allah snatches away the barakah in everything if a person uses it contrary to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he quotes a hadith, أو كما قال, أَلَا إِنَّ الدُّنْيَا مَلْعُونَ وَمَلْعُونٌ مَا فِيهَا. Everything is cursed in the dunya except the dhikr of Allah, what's close to it, an alim or a student. So if we are really concerned about ourselves, then we should stay far away from where dhulam and oppression is taking place, far away from the disobedience and the ma'asiyat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then a person can have barakah in their health, in their wealth, in their time. Otherwise, a person will become a zaman of nafsi, worried about only himself and procuring benefits for himself. In actual fact, we are depriving ourselves. There's a couple who are getting married and the ceremony took place. And the next day, the wife said, I'm going to get my talaq, divorce. So, went to Maulana, and Maulana asked, you just got married now, what's the reason? It's just not even one day and you want a talaq. So we, the qadi, the judge, need to ascertain the actual reason and to see if first is permissible, the wife wants a divorce, is there any shari grounds for this. So she said, I realized things would not work out when he filled the marriage certificate. The letters he wrote was bigger than mine and his signature was bigger than mine. So the alam of nafsi, Hazrat Wahab Ibn Munabbih used to say, إِذَا هَمَّ الْوَلِي بِالْعَدْلِ أَدْخَ اللَّهُ الْبَرَكَاتِ فِي أَهْلِ مَمْلَكَتِهِ. That when the ruler of the time is just, then Allah will put barakah in everything. فِي الْأَسْوَاقِ وَالْأَرْزَاقِ. In the marketplaces, in the crops, in the provisions of people. وَإِذَا هَمَّ بِالْجَوْرِ أَدْخَ اللَّهُ النُقْصِ فِي مَمْلَكَتِهِ. Allah will put deficiency and Allah will snatch away the barakah in everything. The mashayikh used to say, Sultanun adilun khayrun min matharin wabilin. That a just ruler is better than rainfall that is in excess, better than torrent rains. So justice is important. A Khalifa once was traveling and he came across a person who was selling pomegranate juice. So he requested for one. He was not in the form and shape. He was secretly dressed to see what's happening in his kingdom. So the farmer didn't know this was the Khalifa. So he took a pomegranate, squeezed it, and out of one pomegranate, two glasses of juice came out. The king was, the Khalifa was baffled. How is it possible? So he consumed it and he drank the first glass and he said, wah, wah, I've never tasted such sweet pomegranate. He drank the second one. He was even more amazed. He told the farmer, I presume there's no taxes on this. One pomegranate, two glasses of juice. I think there's no taxes. He said, yes, there's no taxes. He said, give me another glass. Again, he squeezed one, two, three, four pomegranates and then he struggled to get one glass of juice. So the king was amazed and said, four pomegranates? He said, yes. Then he started drinking it and it was bitter. He couldn't even take a sip. So he asked the person the first time, one pomegranate, two glasses, sweet and delicious. Second time, four pomegranates. And only one glass and not as delicious. So he said, it seems that the ruler of the time has made some bad intentions. So he had intended to make taxes compulsory on the people. Just his intention, remove the barakat. So justice. A lady came to Dawud alayhi salatu wasalam and said, she said, Ya Nabi Allah, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a just Rabb or not? So Dawud alayhi salam said, Wayhaki ya imra huwa al-adl. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's justice knows no limits. There's no limits to the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he asked her, Ma kissatuki? What's your story? Why are you complaining? So she said, I am a widow. I have three daughters. And my job is to spin yarn. I make yarn thread. And one day I prepared and I was going to go to the marketplace to sell my thread. And as I put it in a red cloth on route to the market, a bird swooped and grabbed the red cloth containing all my work, my yarn. I was very grieved. I went back home hungry and I went into a depression, and that's my story. So I came to you. As she was speaking, somebody knocked on the door and permission was given. and there were 10 traders, in their hands 100 gold coins. And they told the Nabi, Ya Nabi Allah, a'tiha, give it to somebody who is eligible for it. So Dawud alayhi salam said, what is the cause for you giving this charity? So they said, we were actually at sea and there were strong winds and we were close to drowning. And there was a flaw, a deficiency in the sails. We could not get out of that storm. A bird came and threw a red bag sack. And we grabbed the sack and we found there was yarn inside. And we threaded the sails and we managed to get out of the storm. And Allah saved our life. So we took an oath that we will give this in sadaqah. Each of us took an oath that we will give 100 gold coins in sadaqah. وَهَذَا الْمَالِ بَيْنَ يَدَيْكَ. And this money that you are seeing is the intention for sadaqah. So give it to whom you want. فَالْتَفَتَ دَاوُودُ إِلَى الْمَرْأَةِ وَقَالَ لَهَا. He addressed her and said that your Allah has done a transaction في البحر والبحر. You were on the land. Allah done a transaction on the ocean. And you are saying your Lord is unjust. And he gave her the 1,000 gold coins and he said, spend it on your family. Spend it on your family. So justice, the 25th sabab of barakah, is making tilawat of Quran, which we covered extensively. وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ. The Mubarak Quran is barakah. اقرأوا سورة البقرة فإن أخذها بركة. Read Surah Baqarah, because holding steadfast onto the surah is a means of barakah. Number 26, to recite Durood excessively. A sahabi came to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam and said, Ya Rasulallah, inni I read a lot of Durood on you. فَكَمْ أَجْعَلْ لَكَ مِنْ صَلَاتِ. How much? Nabi alayhi salam said, as you wish. So he said, quote, Nabi alayhi salam said, whatever you want to, but if you increase, فَهُوَ خَيْرُ لَكَ, it is better for you. And he said, half again, فَإِنْ زِدَّ فَهُوَ خَيْرُ لَكَ, if you increase, then it is better for you. He continued saying until the sahabi said, I will read Durood constantly all my time for that. Nabi alayhi salam advised him, إِذَنْ تُكْفَى هَمَّكْ وَيُغْفَرُ لَكَ ذَنْبُكْ, that your sins will be forgiven and Allah will suffice for all your needs. Allah will suffice for all your needs. So this was covered in our survival guide as well. Let us try to listen to that, the incident of the author of Dalail Khairat, where one day he needed water for ablution. He was traveling and there was a well and he was distressed because there was no rope or bucket. So a girl who was observing this came and inquired from the sheikh. She spat in the well and the water came to the top brimming. He was shocked and surprised and he asked what was the cause of this here. She said that it was the blessing of making and reading Durood on Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. He was motivated to compose Dalailul Khairat, which is words praising Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. And Allama Sheikh Zarruq rahmatullahi writes that the grave of this author emanated with the fragrance of umber and musk because of his salutations and Durood. So reading Durood excessively is a means of barakah. The amal for today is to give charity in secrecy. لَمَّا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَرْجَ عَلَى التَّمِيدُ. When Allah created the earth, it was quivering and trembling. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stabilized it with mountains and it became stable. So the malaika were amazed and asked that Allah, have you created anything more powerful than the mountains? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, yes. هَلْ خَلَقْتَ خَلْقًا أَشَدْ مِنَ الْجِبَالِ. Allah said, yes, hadid, stone. The malaika were amazed. هَلْ خَلَقْتَ خَلْقًا أَشَدْ مِنَ الْحَدِيدِ, ending more stronger than steel. النار, they were amazed. هَلْ خَلَقْتَ خَلْقًا أَشَدْ مِنَ النَّارِ, fire, is ending more stronger than fire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, yes. water, they were amazed. Al khalaqta khalqan ashad min al ma, ending more powerful than water. Arri, they were amazed. Al khalaqta khalqan ashad min arri. Oh Allah, is ending more powerful than wind. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied and told the malaika, Ibn Adam, idha tasaddaqa bi sadaqatin. If this insan gives sadaqah with his right hand, فَأَخْفَاهَا مِنْ شِمَالِهِ, and his left hand does not know about it, then that is more powerful than all of these. So, giving sadaqah, doing the amal of deen, is very powerful. We need to have yaqeen in his amal. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq of making amal. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.